Whether you're sold on some good old Costa del Sol.
God bless the Costa del Sol.
Sun's out, guns out, Dave. Or maybe you're partial to a bit of Costa Blanca.
We love Benidorm.
There's one thing us Brits all agree on.
Boom, I love Spain.
Boom, me too. It's why many of us say bye-bye Blighty and hola sunny Spain.
It's like paradise in the sun.
Living that life in the sun can come with a cost.
It's about 360 degrees in here at the moment.
It can be hard graft.
Breaking things down in Benidorm.
But when the working day is done...
Finish for the day! Woohoo!
You might just have earned your dream life.
Get yourself off your backside. Get over there, because it's beautiful.
And that's why there will always be...
How could you go wrong with that?
Everything. Everything's beautiful.
We are in paradise.
Bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Today on the Costas, tribute act singer Jolene dresses to impress.
I've actually got a crystal in my bra at the moment.
Dad Ash has some big news for his boy Harrison on his birthday.
Yeah, we've got one more little surprise for you.
And drag queen Aaron Spice is making big moves with his boss JJ at her cabaret drag show bar.
One, two, three, four, bomb, bomb.
When it comes to live entertainment in Spain, there's nothing we Brits love more than a tribute act.
The tribute artists are very good. We've been watching them like most nights in each bars, and they're really entertaining and gets everybody going.
We've come today, and especially tonight, to see the Neil Diamond tribute.
Very good as well.
Also Chess, the Queen Forever tribute. Yeah, come and see them every time we come here.
And 39-year-old Jolene Beverly is one Brit who takes to the stage six nights a week in Benidorm. Yes, 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 she's Amy Winehouse.
I was always a big fan of Amy Winehouse, and me and my mum used to listen to her all the time, and she kind of said to me, why don't you do a tribute?
Jolene's been in Spain for 14 years, but her love of singing started way before then.
I used to come here when I was a kid on holiday, not to Benidorm, it's up the coast a little bit, and I remember even being 3 or 4 years old, just feeling like I was at home.
And her mum also introduced Jolene to her other passion, tarot cards.
My mum got me my first deck.
There may be no evidence they work, but tarot reading is how Jolene tops up her earnings when she's not Amy Winehouse. But today, before she can get busy with her tarot bookings, she's got a pit stop to make.
Hello. Hello, you okay? I'm just here to get some crystals for my friends and my families, and a client as well that I've been working with.
Well, you come to the right place then.
I'm after a couple of things. Have you got, I think it's black tourmaline?
Yes, we do.
Tourmaline.
Some people believe crystals can improve your body's energy and even help you heal.
These are for the throat.
For the throat?
For the throat, for expression.
And Jolene's one of them.
There you go. Perfect.
These are really good.
That might help me sing a bit better. I doubt it, but...
Really good.
That's beautiful. Look at that. Yeah. I've actually got a crystal in my bra at the moment.
Well, that's the one.
That's the one. That's what I carry around with me.
Whatever works for you, Jolene. I've got one in me undies.
You can hold a crystal and say, my intentions today is to relieve my anxiety. Or for me personally, before I go on stage, to actually hold a crystal and imagine that it's taken away my fear. It's given me confidence. So it's more like a psychological thing for me, to be honest. Okay, I'll have these, please. Thank you. Very calming in here, really calming. Trouble is, spend a fortune.
And that wouldn't be that calming, so maybe it's best to hot-foot it out of here.
So I'm here today to do a reading for a reoccurring customer that I've been reading for probably for about 4 years now. And he's hit a few problems and he's got a few questions about what direction to take next. Hello.
Jolene's reading is with John.
How are you?
I'm good, you?
Good. It's warm today.
It is warm.
A reading is normally about €25 and it can go on from anything from 30 minutes to an hour. It typically depends on the customer as well. So if somebody has got more problems and more worries, I'll just take my time with them.
We'll catch up with you later, Jolene. It's still early doors in the dorm. And just down the road, a very special guest is fast asleep at Ash and Jamie's. Ash's 7-year-old son arrived last night from the UK for a 15-day visit.
Today, we have got Harrison here, which I've just been to collect, who is my son, and he has just turned 7 years old over the weekend. Need to do his card, don't they? Do you want to do the writing, babe? You've got neat handwriting.
Yes, it's got to be perfect.
I wrote down Ash instead of Dad. What do I do?
Oh, dear.
Think of words with A-S-H.
Smash.
Have a great birthday.
Smashing.
Got it.
That works.
Jamie is 7 months pregnant, and as well as finding out what he's getting for his birthday, Harrison is also dying to know whether he'll be having a new brother or sister.
We've got a gender reveal in that as well to tell him, so he's going to be super excited to find out if it's going to be a boy or a girl. It's a strange situation. I've never had to tell a 7-year-old something so important in my life.
Ash works as a labourer by day and singer by night and made the move to Spain 15 years ago.
I came when I was 16 years old, so it's all my adult life I've lived here, and it does feel like home.
Living away from his son makes these visits especially important.
Having Harrison over here is like the highlights of our year, really. It's absolutely brilliant. I think it's nearly time to go and get Harrison up. Yeah. Come on then, let's go. Well, I'm doing a little birthday surprise for you, dude.
What's done there?
Let's pull that top bit up.
To Harrison, happy 7th birthday. You really are growing up into a strong and confident boy. We are super proud of you.
Yeah, we've got one more little surprise for you. So you've got, like, extra superhero duties coming.
Yeah.
Because in October, we're going to have another little brother or sister come in.
Look.
You're going to have another little brother or sister, mate. And you know, later today, we're going to find out if you're going to have a little boy or a little girl.
Please be a little boy, please.
Two and a half more months, and then the baby is here. He's going to be a big brother again, which he's really good at anyways.
Well done, mate.
In just a few hours, he'll be finding out if he's getting the brother he wants. Coming up, Lorna's got her hands full managing a big birthday bash at the caravan park.
Have we got enough booze?
Plenty of booze, we're all stocked up.
And it's almost curtains up at JJ's cabaret bar.
Obviously, it's a little bit noisy at the moment, but when we've got the music on, you don't hear it. Oh. Yes, we'll stop there.
In Benidorm, Jolene's almost ready for her reading with client John.
It gives you a nice peace of mind, for me anyway. So it's definitely value for money.
She has a gig later as Amy Winehouse, but first, it's time for tarot.
I've had these 20 years, so the connection I've got with them is really, really strong.
So we're all set, but before performer John bares his soul, he's got to air his sheets. Laundry waits for no man.
From just the first reading she did, gave quite a lot of positivity about the future. Always like to know career, how work is going to be, because in Benidorm as an artist, you never know whether you're going to be working loads one week, hardly anything the week after that.
So, like we always do, I want to hold on to that for a second and just ground yourself.
While John balances his chakras, over in the hills above Malaga, back over on the Costa del Sol, Essex expat Lorna is prepping for a big day and a big night.
We're having a party because we can, because it's June and it's my birthday.
Told you. Birthday girl Lorna Ead,
all the infrastructure's in, it's all been covered over,
spends most of her time working at her day job in sales.
Your plot would start from there right up into that wall.
So is in need of letting her hair down. She keeps herself busy selling bungalows on a residential site on the Costa del Sol. Along with husband Steve, the pair have been living in Spain for over 20 years.
Really?
Best place.
You're not funny. We've worked together throughout our whole married life anyway. It's just the way it's always been.
But today it's time to relax and have some fun.
So we're calling it a June baby party because there are loads of us who've got birthdays in June.
All these June babies are Lorna and Steve's friends and former neighbours on the Sado Park caravan site.
It's a big celebration because Dave and Diane actually have the same birthday. Their birthday was a couple of days ago. Mine was yesterday.
Although they've now moved elsewhere, Lorna and Steve spent 6 years on the caravan site, and the whole community are coming together to celebrate Lorna's birthday along with her mates Dave and Diane.
Just really, really nice couple. I don't think there's anybody on the park that doesn't like them.
Any friend of yours, Lorna? So what's the plan?
So we're just going to go and have a bit of a feast before we go and have the big June party later on this evening at the pool bar.
They're kicking off with one of birthday boy Dave's famous barbecues.
Today, we've managed to persuade him to cook for a few of us because I've never actually tried any of his food. He's going to be doing that burgers and what have you. It's a mini barbecue for only a few of us. And I'm really looking forward to it because he is a legend in the barbecue department.
And later, there's a big birthday shindig at the site's pool bar.
It's really quiet today, but my guess is they're all resting up. Hiya, you okay? You ready for tonight?
Yeah.
Good lad, good lad. I'm going to pop down to the pool bar shortly and make sure that we've got enough tables and chairs sorted out. Got to make sure they've got enough booze, and I want to check that the music's all sorted. Can I just run through tonight to make sure that we're all sorted for everything?
No problem.
Have we got enough booze?
Plenty of booze. We're all stocked up.
All stocked up. I'm always on edge with every event, every party that we do. I don't relax until sort of half time. Then I get a feel of how the room's going, how it's all working out. It's a really large park, and there's 200 odd plots on here. And at any one time, there can be up to 150, 200 people living here or staying here. They might have one too many shots of Zambuca, and they all go horribly wrong.
You'll need to keep your eyes peeled later then, Lorna. In the Costas, every night can be party night. And there's often a lot to choose from.
Nightlife is absolutely wild.
There's something for everybody here, all age groups. There is something. It's a great place to be.
You kind of get bored. There's so much to do.
The entertainers, comedians, singers, they're all very, very good.
And there's something to do every night of the week.
Yeah.
You can go and see a different show 7 nights a week.
Keeping up with that demand is this cabaret bar. It opened 3 months ago and tonight sees the launch of its brand new drag show.
We opened Minelli's with the Dazzling Diamond Show and we are now going to be launching the Sparkling Sapphire Show.
Ooh, I can see a theme.
The next show will be Ruby and the next show will be Emerald.
Priceless. And all of these sparkly shows are a girl's best friend. Especially when the girls are owners JJ and pal Sam, who run the bar.
We want a bigger establishment. We want to stay where we are, obviously. We want to open a second establishment, ideally as a dinner show, probably in the Marbella area, up that part of the coast.
They'll only reach the dream of the cabaret bar being a chain if the new shows are good.
I work well under pressure.
Well, you do.
A queen loves a bit of pressure.
The drag shows are all performed by Aaron, otherwise known as Spice.
So much going on, so much going on. And if they go on in the right order, then we'll be right.
Spice does have an incredible voice, you know? And he's got a great persona on stage. However, could he dance? No, he couldn't. But bless him, he said, I'll give it a bash.
There's a lot involved, so I'm learning to dance. I've never danced before. So I've been taught some dance moves with varying success, let's say, but I'm definitely getting better. I'm more of a mover than a dancer.
And the idea for the bar came when JJ and pal Sam were sunning themselves on the beach.
JJ used to run a dance course and she was missing doing something like that. I was missing the fun and excitement of running a busy show bar. So the kind of like the dream came about just laying on the beach as you do.
And tonight it's curtains up for the brand new show.
We've got quite a bit of a story behind the curtain, in as much as JJ was convinced we needed a curtain that went up and down.
And JJ wants her cabaret bar to be the best on the Costas.
So, after a lot of collaboration, we finally came up with and got the perfect curtain that JJ finally was happy with.
I'm there doing the sound and lighting, and I get that feel off the people. I get that feed, you know? And I'll know instantly whether something is working or it's not.
And this is the result of the hard work of our curtain. Obviously, it's a little bit noisy at the moment, but when we've got the music on, you don't hear it. Oh. Yes, we'll stop there.
Yeah, probably wise before that fan pulls the curtain down.
Behind here is where we have our dressing room. And some of our costumes you can see hanging there. Yeah, so this is Spice's area. We ought to leave it alone unless you want to try something on.
Oh, Sam, don't tempt me.
For tonight to be a success, I need to be able to gauge the room, see that everybody's smiling, laughing, having fun.
For me, even though it's the first show, it has to be spot on from the very, very start. So just fingers crossed the words are in there somewhere. I don't have any wardrobe malfunctions. Anything could go wrong, really. So, yeah, we're fingers crossed.
They're hoping that having a variety of shows will draw the punters in.
We will have four shows running concurrently, you know? So if people are here on a two-week holiday, they potentially get a chance to watch four different shows.
Many other bars have the same show on every night, whereas alternating between four shows makes for a lot more work.
I think that does make us different as well, because Absolutely. People that do this type of thing in the industry, you know, more often than not, people are watching the same show. So I think for us to ultimately have four under our belt by the end of October, from the 8th of April, I think is really good going.
Fingers crossed, it's a risk that pays off. Back in Benidorm, 7-year-old Harrison is rested up from his journey from the UK.
Yeah, we've been waiting for this day for ages, haven't we, getting to Spain? How many sleeps were you waiting till? Say it. It's a good...
It feels like a good 4 weeks.
He, Dad Ash and stepmum Jamie are headed off to the park.
Right, we're not allowed to touch the black bits.
To find out whether Jamie's bump is a new brother or sister for Harrison. But they can't celebrate on empty bellies. Dig in.
So, after this, are you excited to go play football in park?
Yeah.
And find out whether we're going to have a little girl or a little boy?
Mm-hmm. I'm hoping for a little boy called Carter.
So, you've chosen a name and everything?
This is what it is. Oh. If it's a boy, definitely going with Carter.
Is it?
If it's a girl, definitely going with Sienna.
Sorted, eh, Harrison?
His reaction is, I want a brother, I want a brother. I'm hoping that it might be a boy for him. But either way, I'm sure he's going to be absolutely over the moon.
Is it a boy or a little girl? It's a girl.
What did it say?
It's a boy.
Did it say it's a girl? I heard girl then.
The gender reveal balloon is in here. So it's filled with the colour of what it's going to be.
No pressure, Jamie, but Harrison's totally got his heart set on blue inside that balloon.
We're going to find out, though.
Do you know what it is now?
Yeah, we've got something in here for you. Oh, no. The sunshine. We'll have to pop it from here. Come here. Right, so this is a moment of truth, boo. So you need to just put it into the balloon as hard as you can, and whatever colour comes out, you'll find out. You ready? Go.
What does that mean?
It's a boy!
You're gonna have a baby brother.
I think it's fair to say he's quite happy.
Always made me feel a bit like crying. Don't go too far. Victory lap. Come here. Give me a hug. Give me a cuddle.
Oh, I love you.
Yes.
You're gonna be a big brother to a little brother.
Yes.
That's everything you wanted. You don't know what to do, do you?
No.
Oh, I love you.
Harrison is ready to be the best big brother.
I'm feeling extremely happy, and I can't feel any happier at the moment because I've been waiting for a boy
for years now. That moment's come now.
Yeah, are you super proud?
Yeah.
You're going to be a proud big brother?
Yeah.
I'm super proud of you, mate.
I feel like
you're going to cry. Yeah, he's happy tears because of how happy you are. You're going to be so happy. We'll have to speak about the name, though.
Yeah, Carter.
No, I mean, we have to make a decision between us all.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who thinks Carter?
I know you do. Feels absolutely awesome finally being able to tell Harrison. He's, that reaction was above any reaction that I could have even imagined. He's absolutely ecstatic about it, so that makes me happy. But tears to my eyes, that one.
Mine too.
Having Harrison here now and telling him all this means absolutely everything to me and Jamie. He's part of our family. He's one of the biggest parts of our family, so holding that apart from him and now finally telling him, it's just made us feel amazing. Can't wait to celebrate tonight.
Yes, time to celebrate. Baby Carter coming soon. Congratulations, all. Coming up, tarot card reader by day, Amy Winehouse by night. It's time for Jolene to transform.
I don't want to make it too neat because her hair wasn't neat anyway.
And chuck another banger on the Barbie, Dave. Lorna and Steve are on their way.
So I've got sticks, so you can stab the sausage.
It's awful big, isn't it?
It's no secret that us Brits are partial to living in a caravan on the Costas.
I love a caravan.
Yeah.
And I love the sun. So a caravan and the sun mixed together.
Yeah, it's the best.
It's just like the dream life.
One couple are giving their modular home a makeover.
Hi, we're Elaine and Tony. We're in the proceeds of doing up a property. Would you like to come in and have a look?
Oh, yes, please, Tony.
This is the lounge diner. Work in progress at the moment. Just got the sofas yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
The TV still got the wrapping on it. And fireplace is what we bought from our old house. Yeah, it's all work in progress, but we're slightly getting there. Very slowly. It looked an absolute mess, as in grubby carpets, absolutely filthy.
Retired couple Elaine and Tony left Jersey for a new life in Spain back in 2020, and this is their second home here.
And they thought, Spain looks a good life.
Well, the sunshine makes you feel better.
It does make you feel better, as long as it's not too hot.
Yeah.
I can't even remember the last time we had some rain.
All right, rub it in, why don't you? And doing up this property is the latest in a long line of projects.
For 40-odd years, that's all we've done is buy and do up properties and sell them quite successfully. Yeah, it's a straightforward doer-upper, really, isn't it?
Unlike many of the properties Tony and Elaine have done up in their time, this one is here to stay, and Tony's a handy man to have around.
Well, my wife doesn't think so at times.
Moving on.
This will be the house bathroom, which we're going to totally strip out. Possibly new vanity units, new flooring. And instead of putting tiles, we're going to put this wall cladding up.
This is the walk-in wardrobe.
Very nice.
Well, this is Tony's. And this is mine.
Well, at the moment, it's my workstation, where I keep in all my tools and bits and pieces. We're hoping to screen it completely in with fly netting and to make it a more comfortable
place to sit outside to eat.
Work in progress, but we'll get there. This deck in here, we're probably going to shorten. I think it was back to here. So we're either going to put a swimming pool in that way or a hot tub.
Why not have both?
We're not made of money.
Oh, sorry.
Well, we're Elaine and Tony, and this is our fixer-upper, and it'd be nice if you could come back and have a look when it's finished.
Well, we'd love to.
Thank you. Bye for now.
Bye.
Over in the Costa del Sol, there's a jam-packed schedule of partying planned to celebrate the birthdays of all the locals born in June. There's a pool party on the campsite later tonight, but first, at Diane and Dave's place, one of the birthday boys, Dave, is cooking up a storm.
Today, we're having a barbecue. It's part of the June birthday thing, and Lorna and Steve are coming round, a few other friends. We're going to have good food, good drinks, and a good time.
Dave is also a June baby and is cooking a pre-party barbecue to set them up for the shindig later.
Got the ribs on the barbecue. They've been cooking for a couple of hours on a low heat, so they're nice and tender and juicy.
That's going to be good.
His wife is also a birthday girl and she made the guest list, but none of the food.
Can cook, but why would I when I've got Dave?
The couple, originally from Greater Manchester, bought a caravan here 4 years ago after moving to Spain in search of better weather.
And I only cook what I like eating.
Makes perfect sense.
We're having steak, we're having chicken tenderloins, I think, as well. You won't go home hungry, that's the thing. Will the Dave?
And Dave mastered his barbecuing skills living down under for 26 years.
I'm a meat eater.
My Dave's a caveman, darling. He is.
Wait till you see the sausage.
He can't wait. We have a small circle of friends, but saying that, anybody who lives in this area who goes through this ginnel know what this deck smells like, and it's usually, what is it tonight, Dave? What is it tonight, Dave, isn't it? Usually. But yeah, anybody who we invite to come and eat here are all, ooh, thank you.
Fellow birthday girl Lorna and husband Steve are licking their lips at the thought.
They are one of the hot tickets on Olive Grove, as are some of their other neighbours who are going to be there tonight, Lena and Barry. They're another couple that can throw mega parties.
We have this rule, where you go and eat, when it's all over, you walk home and you leave the mess to the host and hostess. So, of course, why wouldn't they want to come here? Good food and no washing up. Oh, dear.
But we fixed that. We've got paper plates now.
Even better, Dave.
Hello, hello, hello. Is this Party Central?
Hiya. Come on in. Happy birthday for yesterday.
Thank you.
Do you know what? It is lovely to spend our birthday with other people who's having birthdays too. And it's because people want to spend time with us as well. You know, they actually seek us out. People say to me, wow, you have a busy deck. And that's brilliant, isn't it, really? It means people feel quite comfortable here. OK, so I've got sticks so you can stab the sausage. There you go.
It's awful big, isn't it?
It's a long size one.
It's very hot.
Oh, that's good sausage. Mm-hmm. It's juicy.
Juicy and meaty.
It's succulent and it's of a good size.
It's the perfect banger, Diane. And they haven't seen what's on the menu next. Oh, brace yourselves.
That really does smell good. Beautiful. You must have a littler piece in there somewhere for a little person.
Right, you said you wanted a little piece of steak. There you go.
Oh, lovely. Oh, that's fab. I have to say, that was absolutely amazing. Compliments to the chef. Superb steak.
I think that's what you call happy partygoers. And there's one more surprise from Barry to wrap up the June baby barbecue.
Surprise!
Yay!
Oh, thank you so much.
Been amazing. The food's been incredible. The company, exceptional.
We've had a lovely afternoon with great food and good people. So let's bring on the evening.
And with the barbecue fizzling out, there's just enough time for a change of outfit before the gang head to the pool party on the caravan site later tonight. Back at the cabaret bar, there's only a few hours left until tonight's launch of their brand new drag show.
So everybody's, it's hands on decks and just getting the place tip-top clean. Mainly, it's the hype and the buzz of us presenting a new show to everybody.
And the man of the moment, Aaron, has arrived to begin his transformation into woman of the moment and star of this new show, his alter ego, Spice.
My favourite outfit tonight is this one. It's coming right at the end of the show and it is just fantastic.
Spice is now the resident drag queen at the cabaret bar and his big break.
That's fine.
What a difference 12 months makes.
Last year, I was going around the Costa del Sol, doing different bars and things, making pianos out of cardboard for my Elton John tribute act, which wasn't a roaring success, I'm not going to lie. And now I'm here at Manelli's, so I've got my little home here on the Costa del Sol, which is fabulous.
there's still a fair bit for owner JJ and Aaron to do to make sure tonight's new show is all singing and dancing.
So we need to work on the choreography. We've got a chance to put a few little tweaks in this one, so we do.
And tweak it we shall, my dear.
Tweak it we shall to within an inch of his life.
Of
course.
It will
be tweaked. It will be tweaked.
Of course. Fabulous,
right,
darling.
Right until the last minute, if last time's anything to go by.
Da 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 da.
Can't get my body twisted.
One kick down. One kick down. One kick down. One kick down, box step, one, two, three, four, there, and Charleston, da 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 da. One, two, three, four, bomb, bomb.
Whoops.
Needs a little bit of work, but we'll get there, we'll get there.
It's my two left feet.
Well, there's no time to hang about. It's all hands and feet to the deck to get ready for showtime. The first night nerves are kicking in.
The dress rehearsal was okay, but that's obviously audience free. So this will be the first time we've done it in front of a live audience.
That's right. All eyes will be on you.
So we're about, say, an hour from doors opening, 2 hours from showtime. So now I will be getting my face on, which takes about an hour. Get myself ready, get my costumes in the right order.
Aaron's doing really well with the choreography for the up-and-coming Sparkling Sapphire show. Now that he's learnt the basics in the Diamond show, I've been giving him a few things that are a little bit harder, but he's coping really, really well.
Yeah, so it's just get the makeup on and get the tights on, find a clean pair of pants, and away we go.
Back in bustling Benidorm, Jolene's just finishing her tarot card reading with fellow entertainer John Paul, a.k.a. JP.
Yeah, I think John Paul's very happy. I think he's feeling a bit more positive. I also noticed that he can get a little bit negative, so he's checked that and he knows not to focus on the negative.
But he seems quite positive that, although tarot readings aren't scientific, he's had a bargain.
For like €25... It's nothing really, it's a night out.
Tarot readings may be a quirky way of making a few euros, but giving people a good night out is really Jolene's priority and her bread and butter.
Music is my main income. This is kind of like a side job. To do this full time, I prefer to do my singing full time, if I'm honest, you know.
So she can't hang about, she's got a gig tonight.
I've been doing Amy Winehouse now for probably about 5 years. But it took me about a year to kind of get into it, really, because it does take time to become like the character.
Making ends meet as an entertainer in Benidorm is hard graft.
Hello. How are you? All right. I would like to only perform 5 nights a week, but it never works out that way. 6 nights a week, and I do about anywhere between 12 and 15 shows a week.
With the extra gigs bringing in more money, it's hard to say no, no, no.
This was one of my very first wigs that I've got. I have bought new ones, but what I like about it is actually formed. It doesn't smell great, but it's actually formed its own dreadlocks. And I was a bit reluctant to kind of throw it out because if you remember, Amy Winehouse's hair was, it was a bit like that anyway. What I kind of focus on is the performance side, so I do try and look like her the best I can, and I do try to move like her the best I can.
And Jolene has a secret to unlocking her inner Amy Winehouse.
Just be skewiff and a little bit awkward, and it just kind of worked. It just kind of came quite naturally, and I'm quite skewiff anyway, so... So it kind of suits me as a person. OK, I'm going to put my dress on now before I put my wig on, because if I put my wig on first, I can't get my dress on.
And tonight, Jolene is... Amy Winehouse. Well, nearly.
So we've got a few more finishing touches. I don't want to make it too neat, because her hair wasn't neat anyway. And then the earrings, and that's it. Orange shoes, obviously. OK, that's me, ready to go. Entertain some people, yeah?
Jolene may perform 3 gigs a night, 6 nights a week, but she still gets the jitters before each and every one of them.
I always get nervous before a show. In fact, I've always kind of said the day I stop getting nervous is the day that I kind of, oh, God, look what we've got here.
Hang on, some of Jolene's superfans are here. They've even had their own T-shirts done.
Yeah, that's good advertisement for me, that. Wow.
Christopher, Susan, Debbie and Graham come to every gig of Jolene's they can.
We are Jolene's biggest fan club, as you can see. And we love it so much, we moved up the road permanently.
Yeah. It's showtime.
It may still be early. But Jolene's still got them up dancing.
Yeah, the crowds normally react really well and they clap and they cheer, but they don't normally dance at this time, which was really nice to get everybody up and dancing.
Absolutely brilliant.
Fantastic.
She never fails.
She never failed to deliver.
And she's picked up a few new fans tonight.
It was just fantastic, weren't she?
Absolutely unbelievable, honestly. Really enjoyed it.
When I'm performing Hurst, it's so weird, and I don't know why. Sometimes I really feel like her, and I really feel like, and then other days, no matter how hard I try, I just don't feel that she's coming across. Felt like her tonight.
Right, quick, on to the next gig, Jolene. Coming up, the curtain goes up for the first time on Aaron Spice and the all-important new drag show.
My name is Spice and I'll be your drag queen for tonight!
And who knows what's in store at birthday girl Lorna's Big Bash.
Anything can happen in the next couple of hours.
As the day draws to a close on the Costa del Sol, the gang celebrating multiple June birthdays have moved on from Dave and Diane's barbecue to set up for tonight's pool party. But there's a problem.
Dave and Diane's food was amazing, but I don't feel like I can get them dance for the next couple of hours. I'm really full.
Luckily, the birthday girl has a plan to burn off those calories.
Chair dancing. Everybody does chair dancing until they warm up, don't they? Or is that just me?
No, it's just you, Lorna. She and Steve are putting together the finishing touches for the big birthday party at the caravan park.
Stay there all night.
Hurry up, lads. The party guests have already started arriving.
I've got Steve coerced him into putting up some decorations. They're not loads, but it's something for a bit of atmosphere.
Nothing says party like a bit of bunting.
I'm a bit away with the fairies at the minute because obviously it's all frantic getting everybody seated. As per usual, we've run out of chairs and tables. There's enough beer, so that's all that matters.
And the community has come out to celebrate the June babies on site. And there's a fair few, aren't there, Claire?
I'm a June baby, so June baby party, I've got to come. Can't miss it. I would snap up the chance for any party that I was asked to come to, especially a June baby one, especially as it's my birthday today.
Oh, happy birthday.
We do enjoy ourselves, we can get a little bit carried away, but I'm sure we'll behave.
Do your best, Claire.
Yes, my name is June, so I was born in June. So, yes, I'm a June baby.
Well, now, we've had the barbecue, we're at the pool bar.
We are both June babies. Born on the same day, the same year. Dave is credit snatching, though, because he is 4 hours older than me.
I'm the boss.
He thinks he is. So we're going to have a brilliant night tonight, aren't we?
A good night tonight.
And cheers to all the other June babies that are here tonight.
Yeah.
So bring it on. Party! Yeah.
That's the spirit, Diane.
I'm absolutely flabbergasted. The turnout's been amazing. A lot of chair dancing going on because they're all big cowards. All the June babies seem to be enjoying themselves. I haven't caught up with all of them because there's squillions of us. But they all seem to be having a good time. They're still there. They're still rocking. They're going to be devastated when we turn the music off. We've got another couple of hours to go, so anything can happen in the next couple of hours. They tend to let their hair down. Once it goes dark, they all go a bit bananas. So, party time. Hot tea.
Back at the cabaret bar in buoyant Benalmadena.
We are open for business.
It's the opening night of their brand new drag show featuring resident drag act Spice. They're hoping it pulls in the punters, and bartender Sam's feeling the pressure.
It's as important for us, front of house, to be on top of our game as it is for Spice to be on top of his, because we're a machine, a finely tuned machine, that if we all work hard and we all work together, everything just falls into place.
The opening three numbers are all really big songs, so I have to do a vocal warm-up. The other show, we didn't have to do that because the first few shows were quite easy to do, so by the time I got to the hard ones, I was already warmed up.
There you go.
Owner JJ's keeping her cool.
I'm okay, actually. I'm okay. What else can we do? Can't do any more than what we've already done. So you just sort of get to this stage and it's just like, well, hell, we've got to go for it.
Publicity for the new show has brought in a decent crowd. The venue can hold 60 people and they've managed to fill it. So now it's down to the new show to keep the people sat and spending. No pressure, Spice.
Very good evening, everyone, and a warm welcome to Minelli's. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy Minelli's Sparkling Sapphire Show.
Here we go. I hope everyone's sitting comfortably.
Well, good evening, everybody. Welcome to my bombastic review. For those of you who don't know me or don't read Vogue magazine, my name is Spice, and I'll be your drag queen for tonight. Okay, the other thing I do need to tell you, this is our opening weekend, everyone, for this new show. It is an entirely new show, which means that a few things. First of all, it means you're going to be the first people to see these costumes. Yay! You're going to be the first people to hear these songs. Yay! You're going to be the first people to hear these jokes. Yay! And you're going to be the first people to see me mess it all up.
Drag Queen Spice is off to a brilliant start. And so far, the crowd are loving it.
Absolutely. They're loving it. They're on fire. And we're only first acting, so no complaints from me.
So far, Spice hasn't made any slip-ups, eh, JJ?
Well, if there was, I'm not going to tell you.
Second night in a row, we've had people in that have just booked and paid in full for the next show.
Wow, that's fantastic.
Brilliant, isn't it?
Really good, yeah.
Come on, let's go.
Come on, let's go.
Another quick costume change ready for the big finish.
We'll leave you with this. This is our little Minelli's family dance. If you want to come on the dance floor and dance, the action's very easy.
JJ straight up there celebrating the success of the show.
Now, left hand. Both hands. Very nice. Give it up for JJ.
With those repeat bookings and that rapturous applause, Spice and JJ seem pretty pleased with how it's gone.
Oh my goodness, after being so nervous and on edge, tonight was fantastic. I think we had a good time, didn't we?
We definitely did.
Great time. Everything went more or less according to plan.
Good job, well done.
Next time on The Costas, Baker Lee has high hopes for his tiger loaves.
Guarantee you they'll fly out in the market, they'll be gone.
And a horse in trouble is a call for Colin.